The Lucky Diamond. Rajnikanth, the jeweler, spent a number of years in Pataliputra and then returned to his native state Rohitpur. It was his dream to spend the last years of his life in that charming kingdom rich in natural splendor. Rajnagar was the capital of Rohitpur. Rajnikanth had his ancestral house in the town. He devoted his time to repair it before opening his jewelry shop. Gold and diamonds should be stored only in a strong house. He had brought only a few diamonds with him. He was one of three or four jewelers in the whole of India who could identify a lucky diamond. Now, lucky diamond was a kind of extremely rare stone. One who wore it in a necklace or a ring could expect good luck. "Have you any lucky diamond with you?" one day some of his close friends asked him. "Yes, I have one," replied Rajnikanth. 2 days later, the chief commander of the king's army suddenly appeared before him. "Rajnikanth, you must surrender the lucky diamond to me. You know, the luck of the whole kingdom depends on my luck. If I win victory against our enemies, our people will be safe. You will be one of them. I hope you understand me. Do not delay." Rajnikanth was shocked. The lucky diamond he possessed was more than the combined value of all the other diamonds he had. He desired to sell it to some great king. "But what can he do now?" he said. "Sir, allow me a week's time. The lucky diamond is mixed with the ordinary ones. It will take time to identify it." The commander went away satisfied. Next day, Rajnikanth was summoned by the king. "Jeweler, was it not your duty to report to me that you possessed a lucky diamond? Who but the king deserves to have it? Don't you know that the kingdom's luck depends on my luck?" asked the king. "My lord, I was abroad all these years. I was preparing to call on you when you summoned me." "Very well, my lord. I will offer the lucky diamond to you." Rajnikanth took leave of the king, but at the gate, he ran into the minister. "Rajnikanth, I heard from my spy that you promised your lucky diamond to the king. I must warn you against doing so. The king is extremely forgetful. You will do good to give it to me. The kingdom's welfare depends on my sound advice. Am I not right? The diamond will give the best service if it remains with me. But I have already promised this to the king." "So what? Give him an ordinary diamond. How will he understand the difference?" "Very well, sir. I will do as you say," said Rajnikanth. The commander-in-chief went to Rajnikanth's house in the evening. "Rajnikanth, bring out the lucky diamond at once or you will die. My spies have informed me about your promising it to the king and the minister." Rajnikanth stood brooding over the situation. Neither the king nor the minister had threatened him with death. But here was the army chief ready to kill him. He decided to act prudently. "Sir, here is the lucky diamond," he said, bringing out a glittering stone from his chest. "You deserve it since I had promised this to you first." "Thanks. Should you face any problem in the future, inform me. I will come to your rescue." The commander galloped away. Next day, the king's messenger knocked on Rajnikanth's door and said, "The king is expecting your gift." Rajnikanth carried another stone to the king and handed it over to him. He had just reached the gate when the minister called him from behind. "Where is the diamond?" Rajnikanth brought out a third precious stone from his pocket and handed it over to the minister. "Thanks," said a beaming minister. At night, commander confronted Rajnikanth with this question. "How do I know that the diamond you gave me is a real one?" "I learned that you have passed on one diamond to the king and another to our minister." "Have you heard of Shyamji, the great diamond expert of Magad?" asked Rajnikanth. "Yes, I also know that he is now in our town on a visit." "Why don't you show him the diamond and ask him whether it is the lucky diamond or not?" The commander nodded. The minister was waiting for Rajnikanth in front of his house. He too had the same question to ask and Rajnikanth had the same answer for him. Next day, Rajnikanth was summoned by the king. "Rajnikanth," the king asked him privately, "have you not given two more diamonds to my commander and minister? Whom have you given the real one?" "My lord, what doubt is there that I should give the real one only to you? How can I dare to do otherwise? Shyamji, the diamond expert, is in our town." "Why don't you ask him?" said Rajnikanth. 2 days passed. While leaving the town, Shyamji paid a visit to Rajnikant and said smilingly, "My brother, I have done according to your private message. All the three wanted me to test their diamonds. I told each that his was the lucky diamond." "Thank you very much," said Rajnikant. Shyamji then noticed that Rajnikant was packing up his household things. "What is the matter? Where are you going?" asked Shyamji. "I am leaving this land." "Why?" asked a surprised Shyamji. "A land where the king, the minister and the commander set spies on one another is not a safe place. It can be attacked any moment and these men will never be able to protect their subjects," replied Rajnikant. Please like, share and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. Do provide your feedback in the comment section below. Thanks for listening.